And okay, an LR parser using SLR one parsing table for grammar G is called as SLR one parser for G. So when we call it SLR one parser, when it is basically, an LR parser using SLR one parsing table for grammar G. So if we are using SLR one parsing table, then it will be called as grammar will be called as SLR one parser or for the grammar G. Okay. Now, if a grammar G has an SLR one parsing table, it is called SLR one grammar. Okay. Now, every SLR grammar is unambiguous, but every unambiguous grammar is not SLR grammar. So this is very important, and you have to remember that it is not vice versa. Okay, if there is a SLR grammar, then that is definitely unambiguous. But it is not vice versa. Okay, that means not all unambiguous grammars are SLR. That is not true. Okay, so this is what is very important and analogy you need to understand or remember. And ship reduce and reduce conflict. So this is somewhat is quite interesting that still now what table SLR and our parsing table you have generated, you have found that in every cell there was only one entry or zero entry. If there is zero entry, it was counted as a error. But what about if situation happens that in a cell you are supposed to enter more than one entry? Okay, so that can happen. Okay, so if that happens, we call that is a conflict. We call that as conflict. Okay, so there is two kind of conflicts. One kind is called shape reduce conflict. That means in the single cell, shaped and reduced both are trying to enter. Then we call it shape reduce conflict. And there is a reduce conflict. If it happens that in a single cell in the table, parse table, two reduce or is going to trying to enter, then we are going to call it as a reduce conflict. So if a state does not know whether it will make a shift operation or reduce operation for a terminal, we say that it is shift reduce conflict. So when it will not know, when there will be say some shift and some reduce together in a cell, then it will be confused and it will not know which action to take. Right. Now, if a state does not know whether it will make a reduction operation using the production rule I or J for a terminal, we say that there is a reduce conflict. Now, if SLR parsing table of a grammar G has a conflict, we say the grammar is not SLR grammar. This is another important statement we found here. If there is conflict, then it is not SLR grammar. Okay. So if the question comes that whether the given grammar is SLR or not, one way to prove that whether that grammar is SLR or not, we can just try to generate the SLR parse table for the given grammar, and we can check out that whether there is some conflict in the in the table or not. If we found that there is some conflict in the table, parse table, then we will say the given grammar is not SLR grammar. Okay. There is another important point here. I don't know whether you have noticed or not. It is speaking about shift reduce conflict and reduce conflict, right? So if reduce conflict is there, then why not there is shaped conflict? Why not there is a shaped conflict? It is not there, right? Reason is that when if you look at your transition, what you have generated that time here, these transitions, you know, from each state, it takes one transition for a single symbol. Okay, even if there is two production rules which are having this particular symbol, this symbol is appearing after dot here, you can see the two production rules, but we have a single transition for this particular symbol. So as there is not more than one transitions for a single symbol, it is not possible to have shift reduce operation or shift conflict in the table. But reduce may happen. So let me show you that how we can solve it. First thing is that this is the given grammar, so we have to augment this grammar. So how do we do augment it? We add as another new start symbol s dash, which body is only s. So we augment the grammar, right? So, and we can say this is our zeroth state, right? Now for we have to add dot before each of the body part here. So after dot we are getting s first. So for s we take this move, okay? So it will give us s dash to s dot, okay? This we get, then for dollar it will be accepted state. So this is done. Next, after dot we can find here r is there, sorry, l is there. So for that we have to do another move, so it gives us s to l dot equal to r. So after dot there is a equal sign which is a terminal, so we don't need to add any production rule for this. So this is I1, and we can say this is I2. Then after dot we have R. Okay, so it will give us S2R dot, right? So dot is the came up at the end, and after that nothing is there, so no rules are needed to be added here. So I3, okay. Then so this was for R. Then after dot we got a star. So if you look at this, what is happening here, we will get L to star dot R. So after dot R came. So we have to find out if there is any rule headed by R. Yes, there is a rule R to dot L. Then after dot L came, so again we have to add rules headed by L. So one rule is there, that is L to dot star R, and another is there, L to dot ID. Okay, nothing else will be added here. And I can call this one as I4. Okay, so for asterisk it happened. Now for ID, it will give me L2ID dot, no more production rules need to be added, and I can name this as I5. And then After dot AL is there. Okay, sorry. So this after dot L is there. So this can be covered here itself in I2. That will happen R to L dot. Okay. So this last transition I don't need. I just removing this line. Okay. All right. So let's start again for further derivations or item set generations. If you see from the I1, nothing is possible. From I2, after dot equal sign is there. So here we need to do something for this equal sign. We need to generate another set that will be S2 L equal to dot R. So after dot R came, so we have to see what are the what are the rules are headed by R. So we have R2 dot L. Okay. Sorry. This R by mistake I have written. Okay. So just R2 dot L is there. Then after dot L came. So I have to add L2 dot asterisk R and L2 dot ID here. Okay. So let's name it as I6. Okay. So from I2, there is no more transition. I3, there is no more transition required. But here, for I4, we have after dot R. So for this R, we have a transition here, which is first it will give us L2 asterisk R dot. So nothing is needed to add it. So it will become I7. Okay. Then again, after dot L is there. So for L, there will be a transition which will be like this. R2 L dot. So dot came at the end. So nothing need to be added. So let's give name I8. For asterisk, there will be transition which will be L to asterisk dot R, and again it will produce the same thing. So it will be a self loop for asterisk, and dot ID is there, so it will take a move for ID, and it will create L to ID dot, which is already there in I5. For ID, this will happen. Okay. Now, come back to other state where there is some more transition is possible. You can see here from I6, we can have some transition for after dot R is there first. So we'll take it for R first. Okay. So S to L equal to R dot. Dot came at the end, so I don't need to add anything else. So we can name it as I9. Okay. Then R2 dot L. So if you take a move for L, it will give you R L dot, R2 L dot, which is already there. So I don't need to make a new set. So this is for L. For asterisk, if you see, it will give you I4. Okay, for asterisk, it will go to I4, and for ID, it will go to I5. Okay, so this is the transition table we have generated. Okay. Now, what we need to do is try to construct parse table for this, right? We need to construct a parse table for this and see whether it is working or not, right? Whether that parse table is going to be a SLR parse table, or is it possible to construct the parse table or not construct, not able to construct the parse table. If we get any anomaly in the construction of the parse table, we say that this given grammar is not SLR, and if it is possible to do it, then we say, yeah, this given grammar is a SLR. Okay, so again, we have to see how many, you know, just a minute. Okay, so what we have to see here, that how many terminals, non-terminals and states are there. Okay, so if you just check out what are the terminals are here, you can see we have asterisk, we have equal sign, and we have ID as terminal. So what are the terminals are there? We have asterisk, we have equal sign, and we have ID. Am I missing anything? No. And what are the non-terminals are there? We have S, L, and R, right? How many states we have created? We have created here, you can see, I think nine, total nine, right? So number of states we have is nine. So what we have to do here, we have to construct a parse table based on this transition what we have created there. Okay, so it will have two part, sorry, it will have two part. Okay, what are these two parts? One is called action, and that is called go to. Okay, so in the action part, we will have ID, multiplication sign, and equal sign. In the go to part, we will have S, L, and R, and there is nine. Nine states. So 0 to 9 we have to create. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Okay. So create the columns also clearly. One, sorry, no need to count here. Okay. Oh, sorry, I have I had to add dollar sign as well here, right? So dollar I have added. Okay, and here I will put the states 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. Now we'll try to fill this up. Okay. Let's see what are the things that are happening. From I0, we have the transition for capital S. Okay. It is taking us to I1. So we'll put 1 here. Okay, and for capital L, it is going to I2, so put 2 here. For R, it is going to I3, so put 3 here. Okay, for asterisk, it is taking you to I4, so write S4 here, shift 4. Okay, for ID, it is taking us to I5. So shift 5 here. Okay, so nothing else, I think, for I zero. No, nothing else there. Now, I one, if you see, there is a reduction, okay, H two H dot, and okay, so we have to see what is follow R, okay. So you can see R is appearing here at the end of the first rule, so follow R. Must have dollar sign inside it. Then this L can produce a strict R. So in that case, equal sign will be follow R. Correct. Then strict R L true ID. Anything else will come in the follow R? Got dollar and equal sign, and R5 we have to put. Okay, so which state we were speaking about? I2. So in this, okay, in dollar, we have to put R5, okay, and in equal sign, we have to put R5. So, did you understand what happened here? We got a conflict here in the same, cell. We are trying to enter a shift operation and reduce operation both. You can see the first rule is reduced here, so you can call it as R1. Okay, so follow S. Is dollar we know, so we have to write R1 here. Okay, so this is the parse table for the given grammar, and you can see here we are just got double entry, or this is a conflict.